You might have been like me, watching Transformers Prime without originally knowing there was a bigger story. The line continuity is what we call one of the Transformers universes. Transformers is not just one cartoon, but dozens. These cartoons recycle the ideas of Autobots fighting Decepticons, but add their own twists each time. Some of these cartoons stand alone, but some all take place on the same timeline. Four cartoons are claimed to be in the same universe, and this is Transformers Prime, Robots in Disguise, the 2015 one, Rescue Bots, and Rescue Bots Academy. This means all the characters in Transformers Prime exist off-screen in Rescue Bots, vice versa, and the reason the war started is the same in both cartoons. Sometimes, the shows will reference each other to further show how they are connected. At times you'll see material inspired by the line continuity that we do not consider part of the main storyline, and this is how it can get confusing. The line continuity is made fun of and sometimes called the misaligned discontinuity, because instead of making a clear story, there's a lot of junk we have to sort and contradictions to rectify. To get the complete story, this is the material I recommend that you consume. Now, they are not in chronological order exactly because things overlap, but this is what you need in order to know the line continuity story very well. Start with the show Transformers Prime. Get to know the main characters so that reading the lore is much more enjoyable. It also gives you basic concepts without being overwhelming, and it has enough violence and plot to keep you interested. It is a good show for people who have never seen a Transformers cartoon before. It focuses on the fight between the Autobots and Decepticons on Earth, both sides trying to find and collect the best weapons and relics in order to take out the other side. Some people consider it the best Transformers cartoon of them all, and I like it a lot because the characters are likable and the episodes connect to each other to build up the plot. Next, read the official lore book. It is divided into chapters that cover the different eras of Cybertronian history. It goes far beyond the start of the war, explaining how this robotic race came into existence, how they developed their world and colonies, more information about the war and their fights in space. It is the most important book in understanding the backstory of the line continuity, and it comes with pictures. It is expensive and out of print now, so check out the links below to read all the books, comics, and things I'm going to talk about. Exodus. There are three novels in Aligned. Start with Exodus, which explains why the war started and how the Autobots and Decepticons came to be. These books are critiqued as being bland, which is why it's important to go into them already liking the characters, so that you feel for them. Now, this book is in conflict with what the video games of the Aligned continuity say, but the video games are good visual representations, yet should not be taken as gospel. All the other material references this novel and each other, so be careful about counting the events in the video games as canon. Transformers: War for Cybertron comic. This is a comic that visually shows the council scene you should have just read in Exodus. Bumblebee at Tiger Pax. This is a short story to accompany Exodus describing how Bumblebee lost his voice and how the Allspark was launched into space. Transformers: Fall of Cybertron comic. This is the story of how Shockwave turned the Lightning Strike Coalition into Dinobots. Exiles. This is the second novel. It is about the Autobots and Decepticons fighting in space and traveling to different worlds. Retribution. Retribution is the third novel where the Autobots and Decepticons come to a planet ruled by an evil alien empire that enslaved the race in the past. The Autobots and Decepticons have to work together to survive. Transformers Prime: Rage of the Dinobots. A four-part comic series which is very cheap to buy on Kindle for yourself. Before Shockwave and Ultra Magnus leave Cybertron, the Dinobots clash with Shockwave and his loyal disciples, the Forged. Transformers Prime: Beast Hunters. Two graphic novels about the Dinobots and the surviving Autobots on Cybertron. Rescue Bots. The target audience is much lower, but that is not to say it isn't good. I highly enjoy Rescue Bots because the characters are hilarious. Rescue Bots, unlike Transformers Prime, is not a story about two sides fighting a war. These are first responders who are not suited to join the Transformers Prime Autobots in their fight, and so they are stationed on an island to help the local, technologically advanced community. This is the longest running show of all Transformers cartoons, with a larger plotline, although it is fine to watch random episodes. If you have children, this is a good show for them because it is mature and teaches great lessons about safety. The characters take themselves seriously and realistically tackle problems. This is what makes it enjoyable for adults like me who can watch the show simply to enjoy the characters. Robots in Disguise 2015, not to be mistaken with another show, Robots in Disguise 2001, is the sequel to Transformers Prime. On a timeline, it takes place during the later seasons of Rescue Bots, and at times, characters from this show appear in Rescue Bots. Robots in Disguise takes place after the war and as Cybertron is being rebuilt. Bumblebee and a team have to capture Decepticon prisoners who escaped when the ship carrying them crashed onto Earth. These criminals have animal-based bodies and are lunatics, and fans of Transformers Prime are insulted by the representation of Decepticons in the show. People dislike the character writing because they are not deep and do not learn their lessons. Robots in Disguise targets a younger audience in Transformers Prime, but fans mostly find that Rescue Bots is better written and less cringeworthy despite being made for kindergartners. Many people are so disappointed in how they changed Transformers Prime characters that they refuse to include this show as part of the canon. Robots in Disguise has some comics which by themselves I actually find enjoyable. They show more characters, break Cybertronian racial stereotypes, show Viacon individuality, and expand on the story of Starscream and Predaking a little bit. Rescue Bots Academy. Now Rescue Bots has a sequel called Rescue Bots Academy, which continues the story of Rescue Bots. They have built a school in order to train more Rescue Bots, but the show is much less mature because it focuses on the students, who often fail because of their own arrogance or ignorance. It is less enjoyable for adults, and I myself can only watch a few episodes at a time, but it's a really good show for children to watch because they can identify with the characters and hopefully learn from them. The show teaches morals and how to assess situations in a smart way. The characters are still likable and, like with the mature Rescue Bots characters, are unique and well written. The show is ongoing and because of that, it has the power to add new things to align continuity lore, as it recently did with Space Traveling Titans. Now there are more random comics, a Japanese show, some video games, and toy descriptions that are all related to the aligned continuity. However, when contradictions arise and the story gets silly, we should realize that not every single material is meant to add to the main storyline. Some things are for pure entertainment. Following the list I gave you, you will know the aligned continuity really well. Finally, please watch the playthroughs of these two video games and think about what adds to the story and what is completely different from everything else you saw. Now, you are set.